Hello everyone, welcome to Shorthand Battle. I am Divya and I am going to dictate you a legal passage of 500 words at the speed of 95 words per minute. So get ready for the dictation. 3, 2, 1 and go. Contradicting the arguments raised by learned senior counsel appearing for the petitioners, Shri Santosh Kumar Mishra, Learned Counsel for the Respondents Food Corporation of India, submits that the petitioners were never employees of the FCI. They were engaged through a contractor, but when that system was abolished, large number of persons got unemployed and therefore various unions approached the establishment with regard to their re-engagement, as there was still work available with the corporation. Various unions presented various lists of workers, but it was decided that only such workers who were earlier engaged on contract basis, their claims could be considered, and therefore an endeavor was made to identify such workers who were earlier working with the corporation at Kosi Kala district, Mathura, who were engaged by a contractor to be brought under direct payment system. The lists were produced and no agreement could be reached. Ultimately, the FCI drew a list of workers as provided by the outgoing contractor. This list was challenged by the unions by filing of writ petition, as has been mentioned above, and the learned single judge thought it proper to refer the matter to Assistant Labour Commissioner to draw up a proper list after investigation and considering the claim of all concerned. The Assistant Labour Commissioner, after thorough inquiry and considering all the claims, drew up the list of 166 persons. This list was challenged by the FCI as also by the various unions before the learned single judge and thereafter in special appeals. It is submitted that after the detailed inquiry, once it was identified that only 166 workers are genuine workers and all other workers who claimed through unions to be employed with the FCI were given show cause notice in compliance of the principles of natural justice, and after consideration of their reply, their services have been terminated. It is submitted that none of the employees who were given show cause notices could make out sustainable claim of their employment with the FCI. On the contrary, only thing that was asserted was that FCI cannot highlight its own wrong. No positive material was produced that they were genuine and proper employee who were earlier engaged by the contractor and worked for the FCI. It is submitted that though the litigation at various stages since 1998, no individual workers had ever approached the FCI or the courts. The matter was only contested through trade unions and various other unions, and thereafter it was submitted that the claim of the petitioners that they were not aware of any of these proceedings which continued since 1994 is neither believable nor acceptable. Their cause were being espoused by various unions. Now, once a final decision has been taken and all the other unions and parties contesting the list prepared by the Assistant Labor Commissioner and failed to get it quashed by any court at this stage, now it cannot take shelter of the fact that they were not the party in the aforesaid proceedings when the writ petition was initially decided. Stop.